The win.
Can you just help us understand, because it was just a little unclear, what's just your read on why you were not able to get back on the court last season after the re-aggravation of the hamstring?
Just wasn't ready.
Last season you came to camp in really good shape. Looks like you came into camp in really good shape this year. It seems like things went wrong when an injury occurred. Moving forward, what things will be different? Just like, hey, look, when something goes bad that you can't control, like reacting to that situation.
Pelicans have put in a lot of things this offseason to not only prevent stuff like that, but how to react to it in the best way possible. So I think what the Pels have done is a good structure, and we'll see as the season goes.
And knowing how the last two seasons went, what did you want to do differently this summer to kind of change things for you and make sure you're more prepared this season?
Work on movements. Stayed in New Orleans for a big part of the summer, working with the Pels, being on the same page with them, my personal trainers. But just really locking into every aspect of my body.
And what went into the decision to spend more time in New Orleans this year than you did in previous off seasons?
Wanting change. If I want to change, I got to do something different. So, like I said, I sat down with the Pels and we came up with a great plan.
How are you mentally?
I'm great mentally. Thank you for asking. I'm excited about my daughter. She's due in November. I'm really excited about that. But outside of that, I just love hooping. It wasn't hard to stay focused.
John, what have you kind of learned about yourself over the last, since you've been in the league, but particularly the last season, over that season?
Things happen, just how I respond to them.
Can you talk about where you and the organization are after 4 years? Do you think they've understood you, you understand them, and that maybe the best is still yet to come? You know, it's patience is maybe a virtue.
I think the best is still yet to come. Like I said, spent a lot of time in New Orleans this offseason, working with the Pelicans, and like I said, my personal trainers, and you know, we made a lot of changes, and going to see when the season starts.
Zion, Willie Green and Griff both said that you were capable of playing all five positions, but your best fit may be at five. Is that your feeling, or do you feel comfortable in the offense right now from what you've been dealing with?
Can you repeat the question?
He said, they said that, you know, you're capable of playing all positions, but playing you at the five might be a best fit. Is that something that you feel is in this offense the way it's been running?
Who said that?
I don't know, Willie Green or Griff?
Willie Green,
I don't know.
Said my best fit was at the five.
Well, I mean, where you may be playing or where they may play at five or whatever, however it was said. Is that, you feel like it is in this offense, is there a position you feel most comfortable?
Yes, sir. I feel comfortable in all positions. I'm a basketball player. Simply want to win and impact the game. So my whole life, I trained to impact the game from all areas.
John, staying in the city, you had some outreach. You met with Kendall Banks, my guy. He got the All In for the Motivated t-shirt and stuff like that. Can you talk about what's helped you get in a better mind frame? Staying in the city, you got more positive stuff from the fans, people that were reaching out and encouraging.
This home. It was just home for me. It's a little upsetting that I have to sit up here all the time and have to tell people that this is home for me. This is where I want to be. But being in the city a lot more this summer was dope. Running into people in New Orleans, it's family. It was love always.
Can't help but notice your first two smiles during this whole thing. You talked about either your family, your daughter, or the family that's had your back. Would you say that brings stay within yourself and stay true to yourself as a family and finding your smile that way?
Something like that. More so the mindset is I can help a lot of people. I can do things for a lot of people around me. But this past summer was, if something happened to me, the mindset was, if something was to happen to me where basketball wasn't there or something just happened to where life just changed, who would be there for me? Realistically, who would be there for me? And just had to come to that realization. And when it comes to family and the city, always good. So I'll focus on that.
Since
an Olympic year, if you get through the season as you want to and Team USA wants you in Paris, how would you feel about that?
If Team USA wanted me, that's a huge honor. But that would be something that I would have to think about when that time comes and if the opportunity is presented to me.
Since we've been around you, you mostly try to keep your private life private. You've talked about the importance of your family and stuff like that. But how difficult was it this summer with, you know, a lot of people, you know, prying into stuff going on with you behind the scene that you have kind of kept private before, but more of that stuff being out in the public now?
When I want to share something about my family, I will. And it's as simple as that. That's how I am. That's how I've always been. When I want to share something about my family and my personal life, I will share it. If not, I don't.
Besides, I'm a father. I have three kids. You're expecting a child. Like, it changes you. How do you feel like it's going to change you and kind of make you a better version of yourself?
She's not even here yet, and it's already changed me. Like I said, family. Family and people who I know got my back. Lock in on that, focus on that, and outside of that, don't really need much else.
Do you look at this more of a basketball question here? You know, you still really don't know what this could be. There's glimpses of greatness in there. Can you look at this and say, we have potential greatness here with you and CJ and Brandon, and the belief is this could be special?
I do. I do think there's a lot of greatness within this organization, within this franchise. But I'm not about to sit up here and talk about it too much. We just have to show y'all.
Zion, earlier, congratulations on your daughter.
Thank you.
Do you have any statistical benchmarks set for yourself this season, or do you just take the season as it comes?
To win with my brothers. Simple as that. I think they all feel the same way. We all got the same goal in mind. We want to win and we want to have fun.
Having spent a lot of time here at the facility over the summer, did anything stand out to you from, you know, watching teammates out there going on runs or anything like that?
Yeah, a few things stood out to me. Before I get to my teammates, I'll start with front office staff, Griff, Trajan, Swin. Those three have been really helpful. They've supported me. They've had my back, and we all got the same goal in mind, and I think that's what family, and like, I think that's what just family is about. People having your back no matter what's going on, and everybody wanting the best for each other. And what was the second part of your question?
I was just wondering, because you ran a couple times up and down the court with your teammates and stuff like that.
Teammates-wise, y'all know Jose. Jose is Jose. But who I think y'all should look forward to, and I'm going to put pressure on him, is Trey Murphy. Even though he's currently out, Trey is going to be a problem. Trey is going to be a problem. I'm excited to see for him to return to the court. But, yeah, Trey is going to be a problem.
Grow into more of a leadership role, maybe in a vocal way and so forth. And then possibly, you know, you were frustrated that you developing into that was hindered by not being able to play as much. And I wanted to just get your take on how you look forward or how you see your
Before I can lead, I gotta learn how to follow. I think B.I. and C.J. have done a great job with leading the team on and off the court. So, I would say those are our two leaders on this team, B.I. and C.J. They've been on the court. In tough moments, they're always the ones to say something to get the team going. And like you said, I got to grow into that leadership role. So hopefully over time I'm able to grow into it. Y'all know I always listen to music, and I have an album or two. But for me, it was three albums that really got my mindset going. Reasonable Doubt, Jay-Z, of course, Illmatic, Nas, and a more recent album, The Great Escape by Larry June. I would say those three albums really helped get my mindset together, along with family and the Pelicans helping me out as well.
We've heard you and your teammates speak a few times about how special December was for you guys, for you individually and for the team. I guess what really stands out to you about that time last year, and what are you hoping to carry over from that time into this season?
It was great. It was a great time. But, that was early in the season. We want to be at the top when the season's over. And that's our goal. That's what we're going to work towards. So, season didn't end the way we wanted to last year, but can't dwell on that. Just got to learn from it and get better.
From a basketball perspective, is there anything you can share what you worked on this offseason just in terms of your particular skill?
Wanted me to give a scouting report on myself? What I worked on was being unguardable.